गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लेसन नंबर 9 एंशियंट किंगडम्स ऑफ द साउथ। इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द 6 डायनेस्टीज इन द साउथ। दे आर the Chair Pandya and Chola dynasties, the Satvahana dynasty, the Vakataka dynasty, the Chalukya dynasty, the Pallava dynasty and the Rashtrakut dynasty. So now let's start with the first dynasty, that is the Chair Pandya and Chola dynasty. Students, before I explain, I will first read paragraph by paragraph and then start with the explanation. The Chair Pandya and Chola dynasties. Of the many dynasties in South India, three are mentioned in the literature of those times. These are the Chair, Pandya and Chola dynasties. These dynasties were in the power around the 4th century BCE or even before that. They find mention in the Ramayana and Mahabharata epics. They have also been mentioned in the Sangam literature in Tamil and in the inscriptions of the Maurya Empire Ashoka. In the Periplus of the Erythraean Sea, Mujiris is mentioned as an important port on the coast of Kerala. This port was in the Chair Kingdom and was a major center for the export of spices, pearls, precious stones, etc. to Rome in Italy and to other countries of the West. The Pandya Kingdom was a part of today's Tamil Nadu. There was a great demand for their high quality pearls. The capital of this kingdom was Madurai. The ancient kingdom of the Cholas occupied the region of Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. So students, before there were many dynasties in the south, out of which three are mentioned in the literature, and they are the Chair, Pandya and Chola dynasties. These dynasties were very strong and in power in the 4th century BCE. The stories of these dynasties are mentioned in the Ramayana, Mahabharata and also in the Sangam literature and also in the inscriptions of the Maurya Emperor Ashoka. Okay, students, in the Periplus of the Erythraean Sea. Now, this is the name of a book in which Mujiris is said to be an important port. Mujiris is a place and this Mujiris is said to be an important port of Kerala. And this Mujiris port was in the Chair Kingdom. Okay. This Mujiris port was a major center for exporting goods. Okay? Exporting goods like spices, pearls, precious stones, etc. And to which place? To Rome in Italy. And to the other countries also. Okay? Students, the Pandya Kingdom was a part of today's Tamil Nadu. Okay, means Pandya kingdom was in Tamil Nadu. Okay. The Pandya kingdom were highly demanded for their high quality pearls from the other countries. Okay. Madurai was the capital of the Pandya dynasty. Okay. Now, the Chola dynasty occupied the place of Tiruchirappalli, okay, which is in Tamil Nadu. Okay, so here in this paragraph, we have learned about the Chera, Pandya and Chola dynasties, and also we learned about their capitals, okay, and in which place they were before. Okay, so now next we will study about the Satvahana dynasty. Okay. The Satvahana dynasty. As in the north, after the decline of the Maurya Empire, the local kings in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka also became independent. They established small kingdoms of their own. One of these was the Satvahana dynasty. Pratisthan, or the present day Paithan in Maharashtra, was the capital. King Simuk was the founder of the Satvahana dynasty. The inscriptions in the Nanigat caves near Junnar in Pune district bear the names of the important persons of this dynasty. Some of the Satvahana kings were known to write their mother's name before their own. For example, Gautamiputra Satakarni. Of the Satvahana kings, Gautamiputra Satakarni is particularly well known. A stone inscription in a cave at Nasik describes his deeds of valor. He had defeated the Shaka king Napana. He is described as Tri Samudra Toya Pithvahan. Toya means water. The title means one whose horses have drunk the water of three seas. The three seas are the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. During his reign, the empire of the Satvahanas extended from the river Narmada in the north to the Tungabhadra river in the south. So students, in the north, after the Maurya Empire became weak, the local kings of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, they became independent and established their small kingdoms. Okay, and one of these kingdoms was the Satvahana kingdom. Okay, Pratisthan, which is now called as Paithan, was the capital of Satvahana dynasty. Okay. The founder of the Satvahana dynasty was King Simuk. Okay. Students, the inscription in the Nanigat caves near Junnar in Pune district has the names of the important persons of this dynasty. Okay. Students, some of the Satvahana kings used to be known to write their mother's name before their own. Like for example, it is given like Gautami Putra Satkarani. Okay, so their mother's name is first, then the name of a boy is given. Okay, so Gautami Putra Satkarani is an example. Okay, among the Satvahana kings, Gautami Putra Satkarani is particularly well known. Okay, he was very famous. Okay. Gautami Putra was given the title, and the title is Tri Samudra Toya Pith Vahan. Three means three. Okay. Samudra means sea. Toya means water. Peet means drink. And Vahan means on which the king was traveling. So, and the kings were traveling on what? They were traveling on horses. Okay. So the title was given to the Gautami Putra is that he was one whose horses have drunk the water of three seas. Okay. And the three seas are the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal, and the Indian Ocean. Means the Gautami Putra had extended his Satvahana kingdom from north to the south. Okay? Yes. Let's see the next paragraph. The famous poetic work Gatha Saptashati. A Prakrit language was composed by the Satvahana king Hala. This work provides information about the life of the people during the Satvahana period. Indian trade increased greatly during the Satvahana period. Paithan, Ter Bhokardhan, Kolhapur were recognized as important centers of trade. During this period, many artistic objects were produced at these places. Indian goods were exported as far away as Rome. Some of the Satvahana coins carry images of ships. The cave sculptures at Ajanta, Nasik, Karla, Bhaje, Kanheri, Junar in Maharashtra were carved during the Satvahana period. So students, the famous poem Gatha Saptashali in Maharashtri was composed by Satvahana king. Okay, and in this poem, all the information about the life of the people during the Satvahana period is explained. Okay. Students, the Indian trade increased greatly during the Satvahana period. Okay. The trading was going from the places like Paithan, Ter, Bhokardhan, Kolhapur. Okay. Students, many artistic objects were produced at these places. Okay. Indian goods were exported as far as till Rome. Okay, students, Satvahana coins had the picture of ships on it. The carved sculptures at Ajanta, Nasik, Karla, Bhaje, Kaneri, Junar in Maharashtra were carved during the Satvahana periods. Okay, the coin you can see in the picture on the screen. Okay, so this type of, and see the picture on the screen, the sheep image is there. Okay, so this type of coins they were having during the Satvahana period. Okay, yes. Now next we will study about the Vakataka dynasty. The Vakataka dynasty. The power of the Satvahanas began to weaken by the 3rd century CE. Among the dynasties that emerged after that, the Vakataka was a powerful dynasty. It was founded by the king Vidyashakti. He was succeeded by Pravarsen I. After his death, the kingdom of the Vakatakas got divided. There were two main branches. The capital of the first was at Nandivardhan near Nagpur, and the capital of the other branch was at Vatsaglum, which is today's Vasim. Pravarsen I, son of Vidyashakti, extended the Vakataka kingdom in the north up to the Malwa and Gujarat, and in the south up to Kolhapur. At the time, Kolhapur was known as Kuntal. We have read that the Gupta emperor Chandragupta II had married his daughter Prabha Devi to Rudrasen II, the Vakataka king. Varahadev, a minister of the Vakataka king Harisen, was a follower of Buddhism. Cave number 16 at Ajanta was dug at his instance. Some other caves at Ajanta were dug and beautified with paintings during Harisena's reign. The Vakataka king Pravarsen II composed Setubandh in Maharashtri, a Prakrit language. Similarly, Kalidasa's Meghadut also belongs to this period. Students, the Satavahanas began to become weak by the 3rd century CE. Okay? So, among the dynasties which were established after the Satavahanas, the Vakataka dynasty was a powerful dynasty. Okay? This Vakataka dynasty was founded by the king Vidya Shakti. Okay? After his death, the Vakataka dynasty was divided into two parts. Okay? Two branches. Okay? So, the capital of the first branch was at Nandivardhan. Okay, which is near Nagpur. Okay, and the other branch was at Vatsaglum. Okay, students, Pravarsen I was the son of Vidya Shakti. Okay, so after the death of Vidya Shakti, Pravarsen I became the king of the Vakataka kingdom. Okay. Extended his kingdom in the north up to Malwa and Gujarat, okay, and in the south up to Kolhapur. Okay, during that time Kolhapur was known as Kuntal. Okay, students, we have read that Gupta emperor Chandragupta II had married his daughter Prabha Devi to Rudrasen II. Okay? Rudrasen II was the Vakataka king. Okay? Pravarsen II composed Setubandh in Maharashtri and Prakrit language. Okay? Setubandh is a poem. Okay, Setubandh is a poem. Varahadev was a minister of the Vakataka kingdom during the rule of King Harisen. Okay, Varahadev was a follower of Buddhism. Varahadev was a minister of Vakataka King Harisen. Okay, and he was the follower of Buddhism. Okay, students, cave number 16 at Ajanta was dug at his examples. His example means what? Cave number 16 at Ajanta was dug to set his example. Whose example? To set Varahadev's example. Okay, so some other caves at Ajanta were dug and beautified with paintings during Harisena's reign. Okay, the Vakataka king, that is Pravarsen II, as I told you, he composed Setubandh in Maharashtra. He composed a poem. Okay, the poem name is Setubandh, and it is in Maharashtri in Prakrit language. Okay. And Kalidasa's Meghadoot also belongs to this period. Okay. So here we have finished with the Vakataka dynasty. Next, we will study about the Chalukya dynasty in the next video.